Hello friends, in the last video we talked about the thrombocytopenia, which was the quantitative problem with the platelets, where we had seen that whenever the platelets count goes less than 150,000, we call it the thrombocytopenia. But in today's video, we will talk about the qualitative dysfunction of the platelets, where there is no problem with the quantity of the platelets, but there is a problem with the quality or functioning of the platelets. Now, what happens normally that whenever there is a breach of the vascular wall and the subendothelial collagen gets exposed, it has got a receptor on it, which we call the von Willebrand factor. Now, platelets gets attached with the von Willebrand factor with the help of a specific receptor, which we call the glycoprotein 1B receptor. Now, whenever there is a deficiency of the von Willebrand factor, we call it the von Willebrand disease. And whenever there is a deficiency of the glycoprotein 1B receptor, we call it the Bernard-Soulier disease. In Bernard-Soulier disease, this is an autosomal recessive disorder. It is genetically transmitted to the offsprings. Now, what happens in the autosomal recessive diseases that the genes are present on the chromosomes of both the parents, but they are not phenotypically manifesting. So these are known as the alleles. So, and the parents are the carriers. So when the allele comes from both the parents and ultimately combines one of the offspring, then phenotypic manifestation starts. So alleles need to come from both parents. This is known as autosomal recessive transmission. And in majority of autosomal recessive transmission, 50% of the offsprings, they are carriers, and 25% are affected and 25% are normal. So Bernard-Soulier disease is an autosomal recessive disorder, and it is because of the deficiency or lack of the glycoprotein 1B receptor, and these will result in the excessive bleeding from the mucosa. And in majority of cases, we are able to track it with the help of the bleeding time, which we had talked in the last video, that if I prick my finger with the help of a needle and I just keep on wiping off the blood which is coming after every 30 seconds, after I would have started the stopwatch, at the end of that time, when I am not when there is no more blood coming, and I'll note down and calculate every 30 seconds, that will go around like 2 minutes. If it is more than that, it means, and the platelet number is okay, that means the patient's bleeding time is prolonged and patient has probably got some problem with the functioning or quality of the platelets, which I gave the two example, like in which platelets, they are not able to have adhesion with the wall and with the receptor, like the von Willebrand factor deficiency results in von Willebrand disease, and the deficiency of the glycoprotein 1B receptor causes the Bernard-Soulier disease. There are two other important platelet dysfunction problems or the diseases which are related with the quality problem. Like these are, for example, when the platelets, they come together, they attach with each other with the help of a receptor which we call the glycoprotein 2B3A receptor. And whenever there is a deficiency of it, we call it the Glanzmann syndrome or Glanzmann's thrombasthenia. This is again the autosomal recessive problem. It is an inherited one. It also results in the excessive bleeding or prolonged oozing from the mucous membrane with the prolonged bleeding time. But there sometimes what happens in the platelets, that there is a thromboxane A2 which is formed from the arachidonic acid with the help of cyclooxygenases. It also is a platelet aggregant. Now those patients who are taking the aspirin causes the acetylation and inactivation of the cyclooxygenases, and whenever it is inactivated, it will not be able to help the formation of the thromboxane A2 from arachidonic acid, and patient will ultimately result in the prolonged bleeding. This is an acquired problem rather than the inherited problem. So these are the platelet dysfunction problem. These are not the quantitative problem.